They let go of this. Christ died for my sins. He saved me. He says, brother, it is your determination, your will, your faith that saved you. He says, no, Christ saved me. As if he's trying to, he's terrified. He says, you want to drown him again, you want to push him back into it. Which is not the case. So you see now, we have to give the people an alternative. They haven't got it. The only book they know is this. And this book they can see, the bulk of the people they can see, man, what mess it has made. It hasn't got answers to the problems. So when he lets go, or he grabs anything. Hare Krishna movement. You know, the guys with the little pigtail, they go around dancing with the yellow saffron clothes and with the drumming. No, look, it is the mind. You know, you want something, grab something. I say, I get peace here, I get peace there. So you join the Munis, you find peace. You join Hare Krishna movement, you get peace. It's any movement. It is what you were yearning for, that you were striving for, and these are just excuses. The straws. It's not the straws that are saving you. So our Christian brothers and sisters, they don't know anything about the Quran. They know nothing about the Quran. If their own book lets them down, what about any Eastern book? The Quran, an Eastern book, what can it do for you? They don't know this book. And the trouble is with us. We haven't done anything to educate them. We ourselves, we don't know anything about the Quran. The bulk of us. How do you speak to a Christian? My Arab brothers, you see, look, no knowledge. You are good Muslims. At heart, maybe you are good Muslims. You know the Quran. But how are you going to explain to them what the Quran says? In your heart and mind, you understand. When you say, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ وَطَهَّرَكِ وَاصْطَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ. Beautiful. Translate it. Translate it for your hearer. How are you going to translate it? So, well, you see, the angel came and what else can you do? You know yourself, you understood it beautifully, mashallah. You know what it says. But now, you don't know the language, you don't know the right terminology. See, you are just a new person here. You know, you are maybe a mathematician and electronics and all that. But this language, how to translate what you are reading, you don't know. So my brother said about you people, he said, look, those Qurans are for the non-Muslim, American. He didn't use the word non-Muslim, but that's what he meant. American, you are, most of you might be born here, you're also American. Muslim, born here, you're American. But he said, no. He had in mind non-Muslim American, so he let them have it. But that also not good enough. You see, you Arab also need it. Believe me, you need this translation. In this environment at home, you don't need it. Allah, in the sight of Allah, you don't need it. Translations you don't need. But now to talk to this, in this ocean of westernization, Christendom, English environment, you need a translation to put the correct words, correct meanings of what you're reading. It's there in the mind, but you can't reproduce it. So now you get the translation, Surah Ali Imran, chapter 3, verse 42, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, like this one here. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. So wa is qalatil malaikatu ya maryamu. So behold, the angel said, O Mary, inna Allah astafaki wa tahharaki wa astafaki ala nisa'il alameen. That God Almighty has chosen thee and purified thee, chosen thee above the women of all nations. Ya maryamu qnuti li rabbiki wasjudi warka'i ma raqi'in. So, O Mary, worship thy Lord devoutly, prostrate thyself and bow down in prayer with those who bow down. Now, if you can memorize that English, you know Arabic already. I have experimented on groups of Arab students in the Ad-Dahran University. You see, I said, now how many of you know? وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهُ اصْطَفَاكِ وَطَهَّرَكِ. How many of you? And almost 80% put up their hands. I said, are you all Hafiz al-Quran? He says, no. They said, how do you know? Well, constant reading, your language, easy to retain. Right? I says, mashallah, you have done the job, you know it. Now, I said, now, how to improve English? I'm going to teach you how to improve your English. You see, I learn many languages. I know many languages, some. I can quote you Indonesian, Swahili, Spanish. What language? Nigerian, Zulu, Tswana, Afrikaans, Arabic, Hebrew. What language you want to hear? Tell me quickly. Out this I have name. What language you want to hear? Huh? German. I didn't say German. Come on, come on. Any. The languages I said, Swahili, Indonesian or Malaysian, you know, Spanish. Spanish. Huh? Swahili. Se tazameni mikono yangu na migu yangu. Ya guwa ni mimi umwenyewe. Umshige ni mshige ni uone. Waguwa roho, haina mwili na mifupa. No, I learn languages, different languages. It serves my purpose, you see. This Swahili opens the doors for me in Kenya. You see, they don't allow South Africans in Kenya. Then when I reached there, sometimes twice I got stranded in Nairobi. 24 hours to catch the other plane, no way out. I can't go out, I got to remain. So I have to keep myself occupied or go mad. So I keep busy. Every Kenyan I meet, you know, the officer with his uniform, I says, you know, I was trying to learn your language.